I went to the Baba Valley in June to meet with my Gaddi friends. I wanted to thank them for the wonderful way their video turned out last year and to exchange a few gifts. I had no particular plans to make any videos this time. I just wanted to spend some time with them, hike till the Baba Pass, and then do some exploring of my own. There were many familiar faces in the group. There was Narendra, the narrator of last year's video, Subhash, the leader of the camp, and Nurburam, the maldar who owns the grazing rights to the pastures in Pin Valley. And everyone was excited to meet me, and some even had ideas for new videos for me to make about their Gaddi life. It was going great until we reached the snow slopes below Pushtirang. It had snowed heavily during the winter and there was still a lot of snow even in June. The hard-packed snow was very slippery, especially for my hiking boots. I struggled to keep up with them and turn back after a couple of dangerous falls. This was my end of summer in Kinnaur. If you are like me, you would have passed through Lahaul so many times on the way to Ladakh and Spiti. If you are like me, you would have marveled at the glaciers and waterfalls in Lahaul and would have made plans to come back and explore them sometime. If you are like me, you would have never gotten around to doing it. And if you are like me, you would have made a big mistake because this is Lahaul. My plan was to do an initial recce of Lahaul to get familiar with its landscape and find some ideas for future stories. The plan was going well until a 30-hour storm stopped me in my tracks. Heavy rainfall turned into heavy snowfall and swollen streams and flash floods washed away a lot of roads in Lahaul and Himachal Pradesh as a whole. This ended my Lahaul trip a few days earlier than planned, and I headed to Ladakh. This is Kyangchutang, also known as Moray Plains. It is one of my most favorite places in Ladakh. It is a vast plain stretching over 70 kilometers long and about 5 to 10 kilometers wide at most places.
So Kiang Chitang starts somewhere near Somariri Lake, near the origin of the Samkal Lungpa stream, which flows below me through Pang and down towards Sanskar. And it ends at Taglanglam, which is on the Leh Manali Highway. The name Kiang Chitang is very interesting. Kiang is the Tibetan wild ass which we find in these plains, and Chu means water, and Tang is plains. So Kiang Chitang actually loosely translates to the place where even a Kiang cannot find water. And it is very true here because you can't find water in these places, and the only water to be found is in the high up in the mountains behind me. So I've been camping here for almost 3 days, and every day to find water I need to walk around a total of around 3 hours up to into the mountains to collect water and then bring it back to my camp. So a lot of these Changpas stay here at Kiang Chitang during the summers. So they camp high up in the mountains and they bring their flocks of goats and sheep in these plains to graze during the daytime.
Plan for Ladakh was to make some videos of the Changpas during the summer months. I got a few interesting clips in Kiang Chitang, but the Changpas I wanted to document were camped in a different location. I will go back to meet the Changpas this October and try and make some videos about their life during the autumn months. Hopefully, the autumn of 2019 would be more fruitful than the summer. Fingers crossed.
Come, follow. I think the camera lost me here. Huh.